We did something a little different this year. We're going to do this within five minutes, but if we go over just a little bit, late into the Sunday, if you can give us some time. But I think this will be definitely worth a while. You know, honestly, I'm very impressed, and you know, with these great youth leaders over here, we had a great discussion, and it was great to see all the kids present as well too. But every year we come here, we talk about Sikh Environment Day, right? And we talk about all the great things that we should be doing, but it's very, very difficult to always implement those types of things, right? So what we decided to do is to create a new tradition here at Gurdwara Sahib. Every year, there will be a State of the Union of the context of what GGSF is doing to help the environment. These kids have worked very hard over the last week. We have a couple points that we're going to talk about. We want to talk about what Gurdwara Sahib is doing really well, and what we as a sangat, as this Gurdwara Sahib, what we could be doing better in order to promote a more positive environment. We'll be breaking that down. Next slide, please.
Okay. Right now in our class, we've been discussing and reading the Zafarnama, which is a letter by Guru Gobind Singh to Aurangzeb. This letter discusses how Aurangzeb made a promise to Guru Gobind Singh Ji and how he failed to uphold his oath of safe passage to Guru Gobind Singh Ji so that they could meet and talk. This teaches us how to be truthful in our beliefs and how to take oaths seriously. Next slide. So how does the Zafarnama apply to EcoSikh? The Zafarnama tells us to be truthful and to take care of the environment. If you're going to take care of the environment, then take an oath to do so and actually take care of it. Don't just say so. And also, lastly, don't be a promise breaker. Stick to your words.
In the annual State of the Air Report, Washington, D.C. was in the top 25 worst cities for air pollution. In air quality ranking, Montgomery County got a D and Fairfax County got an F. If we want to be serious about protecting the environment, we need to clean the area around us. Next slide.
So this was Rajiv, thank you for making that. That's actual real data. If you go to stateoftheair.org, they actually rank and they count how many number of ozone days all throughout the United States. And the Washington D.C. metropolitan area is actually ranked 22nd worst out of 250 major cities. So as Rajiv said, Montgomery County got a D for air quality, Fairfax County got an F. So when we talk about the environment, in particular being a Sikh and a member of this congregation and this society, what can we do to actually eliminate ozone and pollution in this area? And these are a couple points that the kids did a great job as far as researching right here. I'll say it very quickly. Keep your tires inflated. If you keep your tires actually inflated, this alone can increase your gas mileage by 10%. Make your next car model more energy fuel efficient. The little kids actually talked about that. A couple of the other kids talked about that. It's an excellent point that keeps being brought up over again. Actually have energy efficient light bulbs and appliances. Plant trees, let alone if you plant trees, this will eliminate the ozone problem. This is the number one thing that everybody could be doing. By planting more trees, you can eliminate this. Think of it. If we're members of this community right here, Gurdwara Sahib takes that lead, we can easily change air quality in Montgomery County, Fairfax County, and all neighboring counties, right? And then finally, don't burn leaves or trash, and compost and recycle. So, Sangatji, these are our 5 points, and these kids are now going to show you how Gurdwara Sahib ranks against each one of these points to actually show our State of the Union. What are we doing well, and what we could be doing better? So I will ask Jajar Singh to talk about the first thing. They did an assessment of all the cars here at Gurdwara.
At Gurdwara, we counted 61 cars today. And out of those cars, there were only 3 of them were fuel efficient. Because of this, we give you a grade F, which is a huge disappointment. Next slide.
Out of 61 cars here at Gurdwara, there's only one car which is energy efficient. This shows how we should make smarter decisions in choosing our cars, which won't harm our environment. Next slide.
So no more Mercedes, no more BMWs. The energy efficient vehicles on 17, we can at least do that much, right?
Just the Teslas.
Tulsa likes to look good, so we can have Teslas or Priuses. Or Arlene will be talking about the light.
Over the few days, I interviewed a few people from the management and asked them a few questions about the lights. They said that recently they changed all the lights in the main bar, longer hall, and shoe room to eco-friendly, but not they haven't gone to the bathroom yet. Also, a couple of years ago, they tried to put solar panels over the bar, but the problem was that where the most sun came from was on the dome, which is not possible. So currently, they are working with a few engineers to put solar panels in the back of the door, but not enough sun comes in. Next slide.
The Gurdwara definitely needs to make a full switch to LED lights because of their numerous environmental benefits on top of the ways they would benefit our Gurdwara. LEDs can last as much as 20 times longer than other types of lights and therefore won't need to be replaced often. This would be extremely beneficial to the Gurdwara because replacing the high ceiling lights can be a hassle, and at the same time it reduces the environmental impact of manufacturing, packaging, and shipping. LEDs consume way less energy than incandescent and HID lights. LED lights use only 2 to 17 watts of electricity, which is 25 to 80% less energy than standard lighting systems. LEDs contain no mercury, unlike their HID counterparts, whose mercury-laden remnants can seep into our water supply and adversely affect sea level and those who need it. Aluminum-type luminaires are a restriction of hazardous substances compliant, which means that they use no hazardous materials in their manufacturing. If our sangat truly wants to improve the quality of the light while helping the environment, the choice is obvious. We need to make a full switch to Illumitex LED lights as soon as possible. So, Satsangji, we give you a B for eco-friendly lights.
Sangat, Satsangji, you can score at home. Actually, on this slide too. We got an F. F on the vehicles, we need to do a better job on that. We give you a B on the lights, right? But, you know, when I have a car, I have a grade, I have a B, and I have a B, you need a B, right? You need to keep working hard, you need a B. Sansakaji, look at this. This is beautiful. Beautiful, as Trump would say. Marvelous. Heating, air conditioning, freezers, all have the energy-saving logo, and that reduces the ozone pollution. We give you an A. Bole Sonia. This is all on Sandy Pavard. They did a great job. They put all these great things here. And the fact that, and this is seriously when you're at your home, these energy saving appliances type items. So this is the HVAC unit. You got an A over here. Look for this symbol right here because this directly has a correlation to controlling smog or any type of pollution which will not harm the ozone. Right? Next slide, please. You'll see here, this is a photo of the refrigerator. Refrigerator, upper right-hand corner, has that Energy Star logo. So whether in Gurmat or at your home, these are minimum things that we can do here to help out. This is fantastic. Next slide, please. Okay, so Kumen is going to talk about recycling. Here we go.
Satsangji, during lunger, we use styrofoam plates, styrofoam cups, many napkins, and plastic utensils. We shouldn't be using these because right in our very own storage room, we have steel plates and steel utensils we bought, but they were never used. Next slide. If we want to be EcoSikh, then we must act on it. We also took pictures of trash which had things that could be recycled. Next slide. These trash bags had recyclables in them which were thrown in the dumpster. It saddens me that we, the sangat, have gotten an F in this.
No, it's not something to unfortunately give an F there too. Because, as Sukman pointed out, we're doing a great job for using recyclables, but these are photos that these kids actually did. Last Sunday they went to the dumpster after lunger was over. All the recyclables were thrown in the trash, right? This is something that we need to do a better job. So we've done a discussion in the context of saying using steel towels or steel plates, yes, we can go for that. But at a minimum, if we are going to recycle and we're going to take it seriously, right? And this is not a critique on management or sangat or anything like that. Let's go back to the actual report. Right? Actual report said Montgomery County had an ozone of a D, right? We are harming our own environment here, right? If we can separate recyclables at home, we have to go to Gurmat School. Sikhs are known, Khalsas are known, we cannot be doing this, right? So today, let's make it a point. you as an individual, if you see somebody doing this, what the recyclables where they need to go, they should not be in the dumpster rate. We can do a lot better. And just need, we'll talk about trees, because that was the next criteria we have, trees.
The best way to prevent ozone smog pollution is to plant trees. Many trees were at GGSF before and after grid out construction. Oh, how many trees were at GGSF before and after grid out construction? Currently, we have approximately 52 trees that surround our grid out site. We had many before this construction. How many are we cutting down and how many will we be planting back for a jar size that then we lost? As a class, we gave our summit the grade of C. Let's not stop at barely passing and improve.
In our Gurmat, we use a lot of electricity, water, and heating, and we know there are ways to use less. By doing the following simple steps, we can help to conserve our energy and be more eco-friendly. To help conserve energy, we can replace our bulbs with energy-efficient and motion-sensing bulbs, which prevent the usage of too much light. To save heat, we can purchase curtains to put in the divan hall or anywhere near our windows, and they can keep the heat inside. For saving water, we can change the faucets to automatic faucets, so we only use the water we need. Next slide.
When your tires are inflated or at low air pressure, they can increase the pollution by 10%. This is because a deflated tire will burn more fossil fuels than a normal tire. A deflated tire will also increase the amount of carbon dioxide in the Earth's atmosphere. The tire will leave discarded tire waste on the roads when it's too hot, and this pollutes the air. Not only will inflating your tires help reduce air pollution, but it would also save you about $400 a year, and it would give you better gas mileage. To fix this, we recommend that GTSF can have a free tire inflating clinic that will help you inflate your car and reduce fuel consumption, thus air pollution. We will inflate tires for no charge to you and keep the air clean. Next slide.
I'm gonna hit on this point right here. This is a very good point that I'm all put. These kids did the research right here, and they were showing that if you actually inflate your tires, right, that will give you better gas mileage by 10%, hitting on Amol's point on there. On top of that, if you have better air in your tire, it will help reduce the carbon footprint of your vehicle. So what the class is proposing here, next year, we would like to see that can Gurmat Sangat, I'm not saying this class, can we collectively think to actually create that when the news is saying it is going to be a code red ozone day, that we can have non-six and six come here. We have the nice sign outside over there. It'd be nice if we had a sign over there saying, come here for free tire inflation service. We will do that for you. Can you imagine if somebody's driving on the street, nobody checks their tires? How nice that would be if we could get non-six to come to the Gurmat. We have a team here that will both assess tires, fill out the air and say, off you go, because we're doing this healthy environment. Or if we can hire somebody to come and actually do this, right? I think there's very, very creative ways that we can actually advertise the EcoSikh formula, which is a very, very good idea, but to practically put it into use within our community. So this is the challenge that the kids have come up with that I think we can collectively work to actually get on that. Last is Rohan, I'll turn it over to him because he was very passionate. He wanted to talk about Flint, Michigan and actually talk about what's going on there and how we can help.
Today I'm going to talk about an important ongoing crisis in the U.S., the water crisis in Flint, Michigan. For those of you who do not know, the Flint water crisis was caused by the changing of the city's water from Lake Huron to the Flint River. The water was not treated correctly, and lead from the pipes leaked directly into the water supply. Over the past year, thousands of children were found with lead poisoning, which causes severe health issues. As my classmates have recently mentioned, all of us pledge to do amazing things for our planet, but we rarely follow through. We must take action no matter where the issue is. I believe we can make a difference in Flint and help many children. I would like for people to donate to fund filter systems, replacement filters, and water for residents of Flint, Michigan. There are numerous online tools where anyone can contribute via checks or cash. With Narasab, please consider making a donation for the summit to help Flint. Next slide, please. We can do better. Let's make progress for next year's reviews. We're much better.
So, second day, let's do a quick review. What was it? Cars? What did we get? Okay, then what was next? Lights we gave us. Trees?
B.
Then what was next after that? The HVAC we gave a. Then recycling we gave a F. And then finally trees we gave C. This is your State of the Union Eco Environment Assessment of Gurdwara Sahib. Perhaps we can make an EcoSikh, this touch points that we can actually advertise for the Gurdwara Singh. These are the 5 rating points. And then it becomes a measurable metric as far as what we can do. So Sadh Sangat, I want to congratulate these great kids. They've challenged everybody. Let's live the spirit of Guru Har Rai. Let's actually implement this. And we will be back for the 2017 report next year. We'll be watching.